Hey guys, so today I'm going to be filming a tag video, and this is a tag that I wasn't tagged by anybody to do, but it was, I believe it was started by Sydney Fury or Sydney Ferrario. I have no idea how to pronounce her username, but I'll put a link to her video down below, and I saw that she did a kind of Halloween slash fall inspired tag, and I was like, hey, let's do it. So the tag is separated into two sections. The first section is fall, and the second section is Halloween. So to start with the fall questions, the first one is, what is your favorite fall trend, beauty, and or style? So as far as a beauty trend, when it comes to makeup, I kind of go towards everything that everybody else goes for when it comes to fall trends. Right now, for me personally, I love like reddish, smoky orange eyes, like ooh, anything inspired by leaves, ooh baby, yes girl. The fact that it's socially acceptable to wear dark lips and, you know, look like a witch on a daily basis. And something else that's kind of random, not necessarily fall, is I've been really liking browny toned lips. And then as far as style for fall, I can't think of anything specifically because I literally don't go anywhere, so I really don't like dress for any specific weather. Let me think. Wow, probably should have thought about this one. I don't think I have a fashion trend that I like. Leather jackets. I need to buy a new one actually because mine is crap. I like sweaters a lot. Sweaters are great. What is your favorite fall drink? Now I'm assuming they mean like pumpkin spice latte or like peppermint chai latte or something like that. I don't drink that stuff. I do really like peppermint tea. I mainly drink that for my digestion, but it's quite tasty. This time of year, I will be making hot chocolate as well. Hot chocolate, it's not gonna be actual chocolate. That's where I'll like take my boost and warm it up and put some melted chocolate in it and stir it up and it tastes real tasty. Yeah, I don't really have a specific fall drink. Water. That's really the only drink you need. The next question is your favorite fall scent. You know, I'll be hitting a Bath & Body Works and I'm actually gonna go there soon, and Chris and I are going to go on a spree when I get paid, and we're going to get a lot of pumpkin scented candles because I love pumpkin scented candles. They're the best thing that has ever been inside my nose. I don't know what that accent was. If I had to pick like my top candles, it would be one of the pumpkin ones. I don't freaking know which one. Maybe the pumpkin cupcake. There's also one that smells like waffles or something like that, pancakes. I really like Sweater Weather. I really like that candle. I wanna get that again if they still have it. Mahogany teakwood, man. Mahogany teakwood. You can't go wrong with some mahogany teakwood like that. That's real good. And I actually have it in a wallflower right now. And Chris came in the house one day and he was like, why does it smell like a guy in here? Favorite fall accessory, hats! I got really excited one night and I went to Chris and I was like, hey, I'm so excited because I can wear beanies soon. Oh, that's gonna look cute. Ooh, that would look cute. Oh, sorry, I'm getting ideas. Like a fishtail braid and then like with a beanie. Maybe I can do a how to style beanies tutorial. If you guys wanna see that, what is with this sassy attitude right now? If you guys wanna see that, let me know because I'll totally do that. But I'm so excited to start wearing beanies again. Oh, I love them so much. And I'm excited for Chris to start wearing beanies too because he looks adorable in beanies. And when I first met him, he was wearing a beanie and he was super cute. And also my extensions. They're kind of an accessory, I think. During the summertime, it's a little bit too hot to wear extensions. Like, let's be real now. How do you people with long hair be going around in the sun? I'm like, dang, it's hot as heck. Like, how do you do that? My hair isn't like crazy long, like it is kind of long, but I can't even do that. I'm just like, ugh, get this off me. But now that it's wintertime, I can just use this as like a scarf, like curl up in it, you know? Next question, favorite fall lipstick. As I said, I really like dark colors. I swear I mention all of these in like all of my fall related favorites videos or whatever, but I really like the Jordana Easy Liner in Cabernet, which I'm actually wearing under my lipstick right now, which is the Wet n Wild matte lipstick, and this is in 908C. Love it. And then I also like the Jordana Easy Liner in Plush Plum. That one's really pretty too. I like kind of wearing lip liners as like regular lip color. colors because I don't know, I like how that looks. It looks a little bit more matte and I don't know, I just like it. Okay. And then for like the brownie lips that I was talking about, I actually did this in a video. It was my talk through get ready with me video. They look a little bit more red in that video, but if you look at a picture on Instagram, I'll put it right there. But I used the Rimmel lip liner in Coffee Bean, and then over that I used the NYX matte lipstick in Butter. Kind of makes it like a neutral brown, and I really like it. Chris really likes it too for some reason. And then for red lips, the Wet n Wild lipstick in 911D, and it's in Spotlight Red. Look at that. Oh gosh, that's pretty. That's real pretty. The last one that I have right here is also a Wet n Wild lipstick, and this is in 918D, and this is in Cherry Bomb. And this is actually supposed to be a dupe for the MAC Rebel lipstick, and I actually have a swatch right there. It's not as like pigmented because I think it rubs some of it off, but that one is what that looks like. It's a gorgeous fuchsia color, and when you line your lips with this one, it just makes it look even more like vampy and like crazy and awesome, and I love it. Dark lips is where it's at, man. And I also really want to start wearing like some pastel lips too. I really want to wear black lips, actually. Favorite fall eyeshadow or eyeshadows, plural. So this is actually pretty easy. I have a palette and it's so cleverly named the Fall Festival palette. This is from Coastal Scents, and it honestly just has the most perfect fall colors in it. And it has this giant mirror, which is always nice, you know, when you want to look at yourself. I love this highlight color right here. It's so pretty. Let me swatch it and show you. Look at that. Oh, dang. And then it has this kind of rosy gold color right there. Let me swatch it. Ooh, baby, look at that. And then it has this like army green color, which I haven't actually used yet, but ooh, baby Jesus, look at that. And then it has this cranberry color, which I'm running out of fingers to swatch, but this one is so pretty. I'm actually wearing this today with this orange color as well. But look at that. It just has like the perfect combination of colors, and they're so pigmented, and these palettes are so cheap. And like, do you see the size of these eyeshadows? Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, I'll put a link to it down below if you guys want to check it out. And then the last question in the fall portion of this tag is, what is your favorite thing about fall? The fact that it's closer to Christmas, because I love Christmas. It seems like every year around the fall time I start working again, and although I love getting money, you know, to get money. I'm just kidding. It was just a little bit more exciting when, you know, I didn't have responsibilities and stuff like that. But I also really like seeing the seasons change, and I feel like I'm gonna notice it a lot more because I feel like I'm becoming a little bit more aware of my surroundings and the things that are around me. This is like getting really deep right now. I'm becoming more aware of my surroundings. I mean, I noticed that the trees obviously change colors. Like, everybody knows that. Like, you, when you're five, you learn that in preschool, kindergarten. Just actually being aware of it and like being around it and embracing it. I sound like I'm high. I'm not high, I promise. That's what I'm looking forward to most about fall this time for me, is that I just want to be more in it, if that makes sense. I wanna start going outside more, man, but yeah. It's like my brain just like stopped. Like, I was like talking and talking, and then it just like, oh. That's it. Okay, on to the Halloween questions. The first question is your favorite Halloween movie. My favorite Halloween movie would probably have to be Harry Potter. Anytime there's a holiday or anything, I'm like, oh, this is Harry Potter worthy. I always liked Halloween Town. I don't watch scary movies, so Twilight Zone. Paranorman! There you go. That's a good Halloween-y movie. Or Coraline. I like Coraline. Coraline's kind of creepy, freaky, a little weird, a little crazy, a little wild. Favorite Halloween monster. I think what they're trying to say is like a ghost, or maybe like Freddy Krueger. Favorite Halloween monster. A werewolf? Is that even a thing for Halloween? Casper, the friendly ghost. He's not a monster though, so. Can I say Remus Lupin? He's a monster. Kind of Halloween-y. I'm gonna go with that. Voldemort. He'd be scary if you saw him when you were out trick-or-treating, right? I'm saying this because I just watched Harry Potter, but he holds his wand like this. Oh, I must die. What was your first Halloween costume? First Halloween costume that I remember was either I was an angel one year. I actually won a costume contest, which is like one of the only things that I've ever won in my entire life. And then when I was five, I went to kindergarten and we dressed up, you know, for Halloween and stuff. And I was her name Luna? Big Comfy Couch, the clown for Big Comfy Couch, which is weird because I'm terrified of clowns. And nobody knew what the heck I was either. What are your plans for Halloween this year? I don't have any. I've never really done anything for Halloween. We always just, well, when we lived in a house, we always just handed out candy. We would do stuff like at church where you would like wear a costume and like get candy and stuff, but I never participated in those activities. Chris's family does something for Halloween, so we'll probably do something with that unless if I'm working. Maybe I'll make some kind of candy or something. Ooh, ideas. I just got an idea for a video I could do. Halloween candy for people who can't eat things. That would be a good idea. I need to stop right now. Next question is favorite costumes of your own. I actually dress up as like half. I always tell people that. I dress up as half. So half of my outfit was sleeping and half of it was awake. So I was like wearing dress pants and one heel and like a dress shirt. And I think I had half makeup on too. And then I had like sleeping clothes and a sleep outfit on this side. It was pretty creative, I think. And I like safety pinned it together, I think. As far as makeup tutorials though, last year I did a pretty banging Ursula inspired makeup tutorial. And I'm losing my voice because I'm talking so much, but I'm so proud of that video. Like, I was watching it the other night and I was like, yes. Yes. And the next question is, what is your costume this year? I don't have one. I'm thinking about getting a costume for a Halloween tutorial, potentially. Halloween costumes are so expensive, man. I wish I could sew so then I could just make it myself. I'll just put on my wig and my wings and I'll be some kind of fairy. Rate your love for Halloween 1 to 10. Now, if I'm gonna be honest here, I really don't care about Halloween just because I can't eat candy and I don't like scary movies. It's never really been like a big deal to me. It's like, oh, it's Halloween. Oh yeah. I've never had like people to hang out with on Halloween. So on a scale from 1 to 10, I'd probably have to say maybe like 4. Yeah, man. I feel like I'm like so high right now, but I'm not high. That's how it gets after I film for like a long time. I just lose my mind. I said that so seriously, like I just lose my mind. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm sorry it was a little weird and I hope it isn't too long. I'm gonna try to edit it down as much as possible. But if you guys liked this tag, let me know down below. And if you guys decide to do it, definitely let me know. And I will also tag some people down below for this video. Don't mind. Dang it, Chris, stop. Hey, hold on a second, I'm filming. You guys can follow me on Instagram and Twitter if you haven't already. The links to that is always down below. And if you guys have any requests for Halloween tutorials, definitely also leave that down below because I am trying to get some ideas. I have a list, but I'd like to add more to it. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So I will see you guys in my next video. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Love you. Bye.